Are you ready to enhance your device configurations? Hello, and welcome to the Getting Started with SOTI MobiControl series. My name is Richard, one of the senior principal instructors here at SOTI, and I'm joined by Anton, another principal instructor.
In this video, we will focus on profiles in MobiControl, covering how to create them, what they do, and when to use them. You'll see two powerful examples, setting up authentication and applying a lockdown profile using a lockdown template.
Watch how changes instantly reflect on the device and learn what it really means to revoke, disable, and delete a profile.
So when you as an IT admin want to perform changes on the device after we have it in the system, our most used feature will be profiles. This feature will contain pre-built functionalities that could restrict what we want our device users to be able to do on the device, or even change settings and configurations on the device system level.
So how can we create profiles or see profiles?
That's a very good question, Rich. So the first thing we will need to do in the web console is actually go to the hamburger menu and navigate to our profile section.
Okay, and I can see as you go in here, we actually have some already existing profiles. And although the profile name is a text box, we can see we've got some pretty specific naming conventions. And we recommend this as good practice. You can see the sample ones that we have include warehouse, rugged, CFG, which stands for configuration. And then after that, we've got the particular type of profile and then the specific configuration. So for example, warehouse, rugged, CSV, restrictions, and then lockdown.
Exactly. Now, if we want to create a new profile, what we need to do then is to go to the top right corner and hit Add Profile. And from here, we will then choose the different family that we're trying to select.
Yes, and when it comes to the device family and the device platform, please note that even underneath Android, we have four subtypes. Now, just to give a few examples on this, Work Manage relates to the example that we've been working throughout this series where we have a company-owned Android enterprise device. Work Profile, on the other hand, would be an employee's own device, so a BYOD deployment. And please look at our first video if you're looking at more examples and use cases in respect of that. In our example, we'd be focused on those company-owned devices, so we'll be selecting Work Managed.
Correct. And here, as Richard mentioned, we need to give it a good name, and we follow the principle that he just explained with having warehouse, rugged, configuration, and then whatever profile we're trying to create. Once we're happy with the name, we will go into our configuration tab at the top and hit the plus sign.
So what we're seeing here is all of the available profile payloads for a company-owned Android device. And you can see they're separated into different categories: security, restrictions, connectivity, etc. Underneath security, there are payloads for antivirus and certificates, for example. In restrictions, we have feature control or lockdown, items for connectivity, emails, and on the right-hand side, SOTI applications. So these are applications that are provided within your SOTI MobiControl license, such as SOTI Hub and SOTI Surf. And we'll look at some of those examples throughout this series.
And as mentioned in the beginning, we're going to start with an authentication profile. So we need to find it under the security section. And once we go here, we're then able to start creating what our payload is going to look like.
So what is an authentication profile?
That's a good question. So what we're trying to create here is what we call a device administrator password. You can almost see it as the master key on the device.
Oh, I see. So for example, if the device is, let's say, locked down, it's restricted to a subset of applications, for example, we could give this master key to, let's say, somebody on site, and that person is able to use that password to get out of the lockdown if they need to, let's say, for example, troubleshoot the device.
That's correct. And from here, we also have a few settings that we can actually toggle on or off. As an example, dynamic password, revert to user mode.
Okay, so revert to user mode, for example, saying that if somebody has entered that master key, they've got out of the lockdown, if the device is left, it will automatically move back to the user mode, let's say within 5 minutes or 25 minutes, whatever time frequency you enter.
Correct. Now, even on the device side, we're able to go in and configure some settings when it comes to the password. So again, going into device tab, we are able to choose a little bit of information. We're able to customize a little bit about the policy type that we want our password to be.
Okay, so we're able to say, for example, that password enforcement is enabled, and this would mean that the user at minimum has to enter a biometric password. But please note that that's not going to be used for our particular setup, as we're mainly focused on that master key, as you mentioned previously.
Yes, once we're happy with the settings, we'll hit save, and then we'll hit save and assign.
Okay, and once we save and assign, we can see the primary way of assigning is choosing our specific device group or device groups where our devices reside. But please note that there are additional filters, such as filtering on a particular user, if there's a particular user linked to the devices, or further filters such as specifying the particular manufacturer or model. And we recommend those as best practices. Let's say, for example, you have a particular manufacturer or model of device and making sure that your profile is specific to that.
Now, once we have assigned the profile and you can see that it has been installed on the device, we're now able to go in and create another profile for the lockdown.
Okay, so I think I remember where we go. We're going to add profile. We'll go to Android. Our focus is on that work manage, the company owned Android device. And again, we need to give this a good, clear profile name.
And once you're happy with the name, again, we will then go into the configuration section and then hit the plus sign.
And there we have it. Underneath restrictions, we can see that we have our lockdown payload available.
From here is where we can start going in and customizing our so-called home screen. That's going to actually be what you see on the device itself.
Yes, and please note that actually the lockdown is provided to you via SOTI. And the whole idea of this is an HTML lockdown, and you can specify the home screen items, let's say the applications or the resources that you want your users to be able to use in a controlled way.
Correct. And let's say I want to add an application, Richard. Where do I press?
Okay, so I think we've got a plus button next to the home screen items. And in this case, we're going to say we want to launch a particular item. So we're going to give it a name. In this case, we'll choose SOTI Hub. SOTI Hub provides controlled access to content repositories such as SharePoint and OneDrive. And we'll have the action of launch because we're looking to launch an application.
Correct. Now, as you see, we also have a few toggles that we can either enable or disable. As an example, hide item, use custom image, and even launch the app on a single app mode.
Absolutely. And please note, and now you've clicked add, of course, we could carry on this process with other applications and resources. We could give another name, and we could choose other actions as well. We've in our first example, we use launch, but please note that there are many others available, such as specifying a specific file or even starting a phone call to a particular number.
That's very handy if you just want the end user to just quickly be able to give a call instead of having to actually go through an application process.
So we specified that we're looking to launch SOTI Hub in this case, but that doesn't actually mean that the application is on the device, as a quick note. So please note there are other videos in this series which talk about application management.
Correct. So it's a little bit of a two-step process, right?
Yes, that's right.
Now, once we go back here, we do have a few ways to even interact with the lockdown itself. Let's say we want to see how it's looking on the device itself.
Okay, so let's choose our specific manufacturer and the model of the device that we're using. We'll choose our home screen layout template so we can see, we can pick the particular HTML that we're looking to use, and that looks pretty good to me.
That looks fantastic. And if you have any other lockdown settings that you want to configure, again, just scroll down and you will have a bunch of different systems that you can, again, enable or disable depending on what you are looking for.
Okay, so I think I remember this now. I think we click save. And once you click save, we can now save and assign using that same structure as we spoke about previously.
So once we have assigned the profile, let's actually have a look on the device and see if it has been deployed.
There we are, we can see our lockdown is there and it has applied very quickly to the device. Usually it's within a matter of minutes where a profile will assign. But Anton, we can see the profile is applied, it's installed, that's what we're after. But what if we're looking to make a change? Or let's say, for example, we are looking to remove a profile from a device. What do we need to consider?
So if you want to do any changes, again, you will need to go back to the profile itself to go in and perform any changes. But as we saw in the device details section, we are able to go in and quickly revoke or reinstall the profile if we just want to target one specific device.
Oh, okay, so that will remove it just for this specific device.
That's correct.
Okay, and if we're looking to make wider changes, we're back to the profiles area, which includes editing the profile, maybe version 2 of the profile, further additions to our lockdown or something different. Disabling, which will stop any future devices receiving this profile, but the existing ones will stay the same. Or deleting, which will remove the profile altogether.
Perfect. I think that looks very good to me. And that wraps up our deep dive into profiles. Next, we'll show you how to provision internal apps using packages and push those updates directly to your devices.
Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest updates.